What I'm going to be doing here is an unboxing and brief overview of the new Apple TV in 64 gigabyte trim. So first let me get on with the unboxing and then I'll give you a little bit more background on the device. So get this plastic off. I picked this up at Target at a discount when they had Black Friday sales. Walmart also had a similar sale. It's $50 off. This comes in two variants, 32 gig and 64 gig. I opted for the 64 gig version so I could load up more apps on it or music or movies or whatnot. Otherwise, they're identical other than the storage capacity. So, a very nice presentation here, just as with all Apple devices. This is your Apple TV, which within itself looks basically identical to the previous generations. This is actually quite a hefty device than I was expecting, but yeah, good weight to it. Let's take the sticker off here. Now this reveals an Ethernet jack, HDMI port, micro USB, and your power. That's pretty much all you need to go. Got your Apple logo on bottom. So connecting this to your TV is as simple as just HDMI jack, power, and a wired Ethernet port. I'm pretty sure that this has Wi-Fi, dual band Wi-Fi. 5 gigahertz AC, so high performance. So the wired is optional. Here's your remote, which your Siri remote, which has motion sensing and swiping, so you swipe across this to do your controls. Certain things can do detect movement. Alrighty, let's get the plastic off here. This is metal. This, I believe, is a microphone because you can actually talk to the Apple TV with Siri. So you would talk to it through the remote like a microphone. So let's see what else is in the box. Here is your power adapter. Here is a lightning, it appears to be a lightning adapter. Alright, so that's interesting. I don't see a lightning port on here, but it comes with a USB lightning cable. Let me see, this doesn't seem to come out. So it appears to be about it. So you have your Apple TV. Let's take a quick look at the Let's Get Started guide. Here's some Apple stickers. Okay, this is a USB-C. USB-C. Not micro USB. So I thought it looked a little bit different. And a little information on this device. That differentiates this from previous Apple TVs is this contains the same CPU as the iPhone 6, not the 6S. So it has the A8 chip, and now this uses apps. So it's kind of like, it runs apps like an iPhone, although it doesn't use iOS like iPhone. It uses its own version of iOS specific for Apple TV, but it has its own app store, and a lot of apps will become available for it as third parties start programming stuff. You'll be able to use it as a really good gaming device. I believe you'll be able to use your iPhone as a controller, as well as to interface with the Apple TV. One of the reasons why I got my Apple TV 2 is for AirPlay, because all iPhones have something called AirPlay, and so whatever app that I might want to stream from my iPhone to my TV that doesn't support Chromecast, for example, because I have the new Chromecast, will support AirPlay. So I could AirPlay it directly from my iPhone to the TV. Although, with all the apps that are going to be available on here, I'm hardly really going to need that ability, because most apps that I would really be AirPlaying from my iPhone are going to be available as an app, if not now, but eventually, on the Apple TV itself. Another nice feature about the Apple TV is it has, like I mentioned, it has Siri. Although it's not quite as fully featured in the same way as the Siri on the iPhone, but you'll be able to talk to your new Apple TV, like ask it what shows are playing, what or you can tell it to play music for you or load apps for you. What movies are trending or new releases, things like that. It can search, it does a universal search through multiple apps. So let's say if you're using Netflix, it'll search through movies from there as well as other apps that you may have, and give you to you in one succinct search. So anyway, that's it for the basic overview of the device. I will demonstrate it in a later video, and also for those of you who saw my Google Chromecast unboxing, I will be demonstrating the use of that as well, so you can see it in action. Anyway, thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. A couple of things I forgot to mention. This part here, not only does it recognize swiping gestures, this also clicks down, and this is why you need the lightning cable, because you've got to charge this remote, and it doesn't use removable batteries. It's completely sealed in. So there's your lightning cable. So after I've had a chance to use this for a while, I will do a follow-up demonstrating the new Apple TV's functions. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and share.